When I was a little girl, I wanted to be a princess, and wanted it all. The ball gowns, the tiara, and of course the handsome prince. My conceptions on what a princess was and how I should act in order to be a princess was formed by watching Disney movies, Cinderella in particular. However, I never saw the hidden messages of Cinderella and what it was really influenced me to act and behave. The patriarchal ideologies of Cinderella encourages that the notion of being passive, married, and beautiful are the only ways in which a woman can live. The cultivation theory applies heavily to the effects of watching Cinderella. According to Walker, the persistent long-term exposure to TV has small but measurable effects on the perceptual worlds of its audience members, meaning that the audience's reality is distorted by the film's notions. I, for example, when I was little, tried to copying every single thing that Cinderella did in order to become like her and to find my very own prince. Unfortunately, that didn't happen. In the very beginning of the film, we're introduced to Cinderella, who takes on traditional roles of a woman by housekeeping and cooking as well. According to Higgs, Cinderella is forced into a life of servitude by her stepmother, Lady Tremaine. But when we see her scrubbing the floor, she does so while singing about nightingales. Even though she's abused and taken advantage of, she does nothing in order to combat the abuse. She passively takes it. This passive behavior is similar to the ideas written in The Good Wife's Guide. Now, The Good Wife's Guide writes, "Clear away clutter, prepare yourself, and don't greet him with complaints and problems." These are all actions that Cinderella exhibited throughout the movie. We see her cleaning in order to go see the prince. We see her becoming more beautiful and getting a gown to impress the prince. And we also never see her complaining or talking about her problems with the prince. All the actions that the movie portrays enforces that the audience should also be doing these things and that it's okay for them to be doing these things as long as they get the man in the end. According to Parsons, after meek submissions, humble acceptance of her fate, being good to those who abused her, and becoming beautiful, Cinderella is rewarded with the prince, yet she did nothing. The film also conveys that marriage is Cinderella's only escape out of her abusive life. She literally has to wait for a man to come in and save the day. The prince also feeds into stereotypical male roles of being handsome, strong, and, of course, the key to fixing all of the problems. Despite other options like education or even a career, Cinderella's only way to a better life is through marriage. Now, the idea of beauty is also stressed throughout the film. According to the American Psychological Association, like many other animations, cartoons primarily portray girls as domestic, interested in boys, concerned with their appearance, and this is suggesting that there's an overemphasis on the self as a romantic object, if not necessarily a sexual one. Now, Prince Charming falls in love with Cinderella solely based on her attractiveness. I have a clip here of when they first met.
Here's the maid of the destiny. He is bright. Pretty pot for fairy tale fire, but in real life, oh, no. It was foredoomed to failure. Failure, eh? Take a look at that, you pompous windbag! Who is she? Do you know her? Who, sire? I've never seen her before. That's one thing in her favor. The waltz! Quick, the waltz!
So basically, after one dance, these two fall madly in love with each other, and they don't even know each other's names. Now, these messages can be extremely troubling to children who watch the films, because they can be informed on the wrong notions of how relationships work and how love works. From Cinderella, children may perceive that if you take care in your appearance, that you're going to find a wealthy and a wonderful, handsome husband. And after being with each other for one night, Cinderella and Prince Charming are already deeply and madly in love, but they still lack that communication. According to England and Collier Meek, the film provides a child viewer with a consistent exposure to the social script that one falls in love, either very quickly, at first sight, against all odds, or both. conclusion, perhaps it was best for me not to become a princess after all. If becoming a princess means depending on a man to succeed, it's something I would never sign up for. Cinderella, however classic it may be, has some outdated messages that need to be exposed in order to prevent women in the future to thinking that it's okay to become the damsel in distress.